Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to discuss OPAM and Linear ISIS Laboratory. Subject code is 18EEL48 with Professor D.A. Venila and Professor Ramya. So the experiment number we are going to see is 7. Design and realize an OPAM based function generator to generate sine waveform, square waveform, triangular waveform of desired frequency. Aim: to design a circuit to generate square waveform and triangular waveform of desired frequency. This is the circuit diagram of OPAM based function generator. The first part of the circuit is nothing but your astable multivibrator followed by that integrator circuit. The output of the astable multivibrator will be at pin number VO1 and output of the integrator will be at VO2. Here we are generating the square waveform and the triangular waveform without giving input. Here the OPAM application will be the function generator. How the OPAM will be generating the square waveform and triangular waveform will be see by using design and the practical circuit. This is the design. We are going to design 1 kHz frequency. The astable multivibrator circuit design part is, the astable multivibrator generates square waveform which is t is equal to 2 RF C ln of 1 plus beta divided by 1 minus beta, and when R1 equal to 1.16 R2, we have your T is equal to 2 times RFC. You are going to choose the capacitance value 0.1 microfarad, and then RF will be your 4.7 kilo ohm. Then R1 will be 1.16 R2. So R2 we are going to take 4.7 kilo ohm, therefore your R1 will be 5.6 kilo ohm. Next, coming to the integrator design part, if you want to design a good integrator, we have to choose the time constant should be RC should be greater than T, that is the total time period of the triangular waveform. So the total time period we are going to take, your RC will be equal to 10 times T. So and choose a capacitance value 0.22 microfarad. From that we are going to find the R3 value, which is 47 kilo ohm. And your R4 is nothing but your gain limiting resistance, that should be 10 times R3, so it will be 470 kilo ohm. Now coming to the procedure, the connections are made as per the circuit diagram and the biasing voltage will be given via DC supply at pin number 7, which is VCC 12 volt, and pin number 4, which is VEE minus 12 volt. Now we are going to observe the output voltage at VO1, which is nothing but your square waveform of your astable multivibrator, and VO2, which is nothing but your triangular waveform obtained from the integrator circuit. Now we are going to verify the practical frequency with the theoretical frequency. So theoretical frequency, already I have told that we are going to design for 1 kHz, so that will be verified with your practical frequency. Now this is the expected output waveform of your astable multivibrator. Astable multivibrator output is nothing but your square waveform, and which is obtained at pin number 6 of your first part, that is nothing but VO1, and your next part is your triangular waveform, which is going to obtain from the integrator at VO2. Now I am going to play the practical demonstration video. Please watch this video. As per the circuit diagram, the connections are given, and here we have given the dual power supply for biasing plus VCC at pin number 7 and minus VE at pin number 4. Okay. So here the first op-amp, this first op-amp is act as a astable multivibrator, that is the output of the astable multivibrator will be square waveform, and the second one will be the integrator. Okay, the integrator output will be the triangular waveform. If you give if you integrate the square waveform, you will get the triangular waveform. But that is theoretical, but practically how the square waveform will be integrated using OPAM, that I have shown here, right? See, this is nothing but your symmetrical output, that is square wave, triangular waveform. If you give the input as a square waveform for any integrator, you will get the output triangular waveform. So here, without function generator, we are generating the square waveform and triangular waveform. So using OPAM, we can generate square waveform, sine waveform, triangular waveform, pulse, all those things. So this is the output. Now we have seen the practical circuit diagram of your function generator. From that we have drawn the waveform, output waveform, and this is the result is as the op amp is realized as a function generator using IC741 to generate square waveform, sine waveform, triangular waveform, and this one. Thank you, students.